All right. Do you know where you're going to? And do you like the things that life is showing you? Tell me, do you know? My brother, tell me, do you know? For I know the plans I have for you.
Plans for you to prosper and not bring you home.
Not bring you home.
Your life is safe with me, no need for a loan.
There is no need.
If you call on me, I will hear what you say.
Hear what you say.
This is not your end, you will see brighter days.
And even if it rains all day,
the sun again will soon show.
Soon show.
The flowers and trees, the grass needs rain to grow.
Grow.
So grab your umbrella, Ella, and go and dance in the rain. No matter the weather,
there will be brighter days.
Hello, how are you? I'm singer-songwriter and gospel recording artist Richard Hollis.
So protective of you, yeah. I'm so in love.
First and foremost, I'm a child of God. Next, I'm a husband and a father. Married for 14 years now, this year. Been together 17. I have a 17-year-old daughter and a 10-year-old son. Heavily involved with youth sports, basketball, coaching. When I'm not doing music or ministry, that is what I'm doing full time. Fell in love with music around, I'd say, 5 or 6 years old. Growing up, son of a Pentecostal preacher, and in church every Sunday. My family was very musically inclined. I mean, most preachers' kids would know we were the choir. Two of my brothers played guitars, one played drums, the other played the organ and piano. So I can remember one of the first things I wanted to do was get on the drums. So I began to start playing drums, and the next thing I fell in love with was singing. I guess I would say around the age of 14, I began to start listening to John P. Key. I fell in love with his style of music and the way he did gospel music. But I began to listen to secular music as well. And there was a group by the name of Jodeci that really left a lasting impression upon me until this day. And you know, me being the son of a preacher coming out of church, my thing was, hey, well, these boys came out of church and they able to do it, so why can't I do it? So, man, you know, I fell in love with their style, and since then they've been a very, very strong influence on what I do musically. Some of my other influences are Sam Cooke, Jagged Edge, Dave Hollister for sure. Gospel Ed, I would say Fred Hammond, some Dietrich Haddon, Marvin Sapp. New music I'm working on is an EP entitled Brighter Days. I'm really excited about this EP and the new material that I have, because I can say this is the first time since I've been doing gospel music that I feel a peace about what I'm doing. What I've been able to write, what I've been able to record, I really believe that it represents me well. From the style of music that I do with the soul. I mean, that's one thing I can never take out of my voice is the soul. I believe that the more neo-soul, soul, R&B style of music represents me well. Because it is me. I mean, even though I grew up a PK, my heart is deeply rooted in R&B. And if my music didn't somehow follow that, I wouldn't be true to myself.
The flowers and trees, the grass needs rain to grow. So grab your umbrella.
But the new music that I'm writing about, the new material, I'm just writing about life. you know, writing about lives, life's ups and downs, life challenges. But the meat of the message is that no matter what we're going through, no matter what our situations are, no matter what happens in life, Jesus Christ is and will forever be the answer. I just want to encourage people, whether you're a child of God, whether you're not, you know, whether you've accepted Jesus Christ or not, I just want to encourage you in the ways of Christ. You know, I believe that myself and anyone that God has placed a calling on their lives, and that is and the person that has accepted that calling, that our first mission, no matter what our gifts may be, our first mission is to reconcile the hearts of men and women back to Christ. So if that may be through a music ministry, that may be through a preaching ministry, that may be through cooking or just the ministry of helps, whatever it may be, our main goal is to reconcile the hearts of men and women back to Christ. I'm excited about this new project because this new EP, because it's encouragement. I mean, on a day-to-day basis, I still work a 9-to-5. And on a day-to-day basis, I meet people. I have the opportunity through my job to meet a lot of people from all different walks of life. And people are hurting. No matter how you try to put a mask over it, no matter what your economic status is, everyone is going through something. You know, I just want this album, Brighter Days, to be the salve that goes over those wounds, to be the music that you listen to when you need that pick-me-up, when you need that pick-me-up throughout the day. It's coming to you fresh, it's coming to you raw, it's coming to you with just a sense of encouragement, a sense of uplifting. You know, and hence the title, Brighter Days. So I just want to encourage you and let you know that no matter what your situation may be, no matter how the rain may be falling or the storms may be blowing in your lives right now, there will be brighter days. God bless you, Richard Hollis.